Look, look at this. So many, so many. A massive pile. But where did all these spheres come from? Why are there so many? Why are they in this exact place? And why are they all so perfectly round? Just look at this beauty. Look how incredible this is. The entire ground is covered in these spheres. It's like some giant was transporting them in a truck, and they all spilled out. How is this even possible? I've arrived at the Valley of Balls. Why is it called the Valley of Balls? Because it's a valley, and it's filled with these massive stone spheres, thousands upon thousands of them. They come in all different sizes, some split in half, some covered in layers, some perfectly smooth and whole. From tiny ones you can pick up with your hand to enormous ones several meters across. It's absolutely mind-blowing. And just look at this view from the farthest point we reach by car. Look at this. This is unreal. It feels like a painting, like some giant panoramic wallpaper. And especially now, since we arrived quite late, the sun is already setting, it's getting dark. But in this golden light, the view is just breathtaking. I need to go down and touch one. There are so many. Look, there's a whole bunch here, and even more up on that hill. Way up there. How are they not rolling down? They're just sitting on the slope. And over there, look, more of them. Just resting on the hillside, not moving an inch. And that one over there. Doesn't it look like a giant billiard ball? Like it was polished on purpose. How did nature create such perfect spheres? Seriously, this is unreal. It's pure magic. How? Just how? Look at this one. It's about 5 feet across. And it's layered. Check out the inside. It looks almost like granite, or maybe basalt, and then another layer on top. Like it was built up over time. And here's a flattened one. Still a sphere, but squashed. Covered in shell fragments, but inside, it looks like it has a core. And this one, wow. A massive rock, perfectly round. And look at these broken pieces. Some of them have shattered into several parts. I don't see any really tiny ones, though. I guess people have taken all the small ones as souvenirs. Look, so many. So many, a massive pile. And even further ahead, there are even more of them, a huge number. And over there, just look, more and more of them. I have to come back here again. Before coming, I did some quick Googling to find out what these are. And according to Wikipedia, scientists don't have a definite answer. There are different theories, but no one really knows how they formed. I also found a beautiful legend. According to the legend, long ago, there was an evil warlord. Don't ask me his name, I forgot. But he gathered a huge army and was about to go to war against the good people. But the good leader, whose name I also forgot, turned the entire army into these stone spheres. And look at this one. It's not completely round. A strange shape, but underneath, look, there are smaller spheres fused to it, holding it up like little supports. How? How did this happen? One big sphere and then another one just stuck to it? And they're both almost perfectly round. It's just mind-blowing. This is one of those moments. When I came over that little hill and saw all of this, I just went, ah. Who? Wishing you happiness, health, love, and patience. And if you ever get the chance, you absolutely must visit the Valley of Balls, located near the beautiful Caspian Sea, in the amazing welcoming country of Kazakhstan, close to the charming city of Aktau. That's all for today. See you next time.